church-based show. It's really good. It's murder mystery. It, like, brings you in and gives you weird feelings inside. It's like, oh my god, did they murder someone? Like, they just murdered someone. I watched it happen. It's nuts. So you should check that out. Check out all of Wet Seasonal Disorder. Lots of shows coming up. And our second group tonight is called Lizard Girl. And we're going to get a little, like, popping like this.
A word of something that you would like to see a show about.
Dinosaur.
Dinosaur? Jurassic Park. Cool.
We know dinosaurs. They are a prehistoric creature that essentially ruled the Earth, and then something terrible happened to them, and now they don't rule the Earth anymore than we do.
The kids call this a dinosaur, but I don't see the problem with my Mac O's. It has a nice big screen, and the clicker is large.
Hello, Kyle, my grandson. Oh, you're not visiting me again. I knew it.
When I was in middle school, it was really cool to own an iguana, but my mom wouldn't let me have one then, so I have one now. I'm digging it.
Sometimes there are things that are embarrassing in your life. One of them is that I liked Barney secretly for a lot longer than I ever wanted to admit.
The elementary school that I went to and started my educational journey at taught that Adam and Eve were like in the first paragraph of our biology book. And so my adulthood has been filled with like learning a lot of facts.
We see a giant amber bulb, you know, the kind that was in the film Jurassic Park, held by the old man on top of a cane. And inside of that amber bulb is a tiny little insect, and inside of that tiny little insect is a tiny little bit of food.
I like to think if the dinosaurs, when they ruled the world, if they were a lot like us, like when they, if they would have gone outside today, would they have thought it's like way too cold outside?
I'm fine. I'm fine. Sharon here. I do have a PhD in biology, and I did sedate that velociraptor without the help of Chris Pratt. Thank you very much.
I don't see what the kids are seeing with their little tiny hand computers. My computer's so big, and I play Pong.
Good news, Ruth. Kyle, my grandson, canceled so we can have promiscuous retirement home sex.
I named my iguana Steve. Turns out Steve is actually a girl, but I'm cool with it.
Still remember that white VHS cassette tape of Barney I used to steal from my little sister and then quietly watch in my parents' bedroom when no one was around. At the age of 9, maybe 10, I might have been older.
For instance, just this week I was having a conversation with someone about rainbows, and I know, like I knew that happened with light refracting and water and the whole deal, but it did take me a second to shake, like, oh no, it's not a promise that the world won't end again.
So the other really cool thing about those little tiny bugs trapped in amber is that they are kind of like a distillation of a moment in history that's forever preserved until time ends.
Dinosaur!
Richard, I'm finally going to beat you at checkers. I'm quite confident.
Tony, do you remember that boy who used to get me my turkey sandwiches?
Clifford, yes. I remember Clifford quite well.
He just quit today.
What?
He said it was because the old cronies here gave him too much shit.
No, no.
King me.
Clifford! Another one bites the dust.
Another one bites the dust.
The employees here are leaving faster than we are. I'm too healthy for this place. I thought I would be here 6-7 months. 11 years later, here we are. I'll take her.
You usually stay here for good, you know that?
I know, but what I'm saying is, I didn't think for good would be so long.
Oh! Okay, yes, I see your point.
Pills for you and you. Here's a ham sandwich.
I said turkey!
I think she just gave us pills at random.
Well, down the hatch.
Down the hatch.
Oh. Tony, with help like this, I can't believe you stayed alive so long getting mystery pills. What's your secret? I want to live forever. I want to blow this joint.
Well, I'll tell you. 13 hours of sleep every night, cottage cheese for breakfast, and aerobics in the evening.
Hello, happy day residents.
Oh, please.
Happy evening. Just want to let you know that in the TV room, we will be changing the History Channel to C-SPAN. And we'll be on that channel for the next 5 hours.
Girl, we better get over there.
I'm so glad that we're best friends. Like, when I first came to college and I was a freshman, I didn't think I'd have any friends. I had a single room. And now, here we are.
I have to tell you a little bit of history about our best friendship. You might not know.
I love the history of our best friendship, Brian. Tell me.
It's planned. Our friendship.
Of course it was planned. It was
no, my dad works for the CIA.
The whole thing.
Wait, what?
You know how you're Lithuanian?
Sorry, I know what country I'm from. Right. I did not know that your dad was a spy. I thought he worked for Geico with a little gecko that sold insurance.
Oh, that gecko. No. No, that's a handgun. Look, I'm coming clean to you because I felt guilty. My father has been hunting Lithuanian bioengineering spies for decades. Your dad, he's kind of an emissary of the Lithuanian version of the Kremlin.
You know exactly what that means. He is a Lithuanian version of the Kremlin and an emissary. What I didn't know, Ryan, is that your dad was using me, and you were using me.
Well, technically he was using me to use you. We're just keeping the semantics right, because I want our friendship to go further. Look, my dad set you in a single room at that college, and technically, I'm not his son, I'm actually a recruit. A junior CIA operative, but that's neither here nor there. He's my dad for all intents and purposes of this story. And I was sent there to be both alluring and a friend, almost like a boyfriend, but like never too close because of the spy thing. And to get the secret code to the bioengineering chamber so that I could get those dinosaurs that your country is bioengineering to defeat us in potential warfare.
Listen, Ryan, put the dinosaurs to the side.
Wait, did you just confirm the dinosaurs?
All right, kids. Kid, we're just here.
I have friends, I promise. They just think they had other stuff going on.
It's fine. This is better. We are teacher trainees. We're co-teaching today, kindergarten, so thank you for being a great audience.
Here's a hat.
And the first lesson that we're going to have today is about these chicks, these baby chicks that we've adopted.
My mom says I'm not allowed to call anything a chick.
See, that's good. But this one, this is one.
How can you tell the difference of what?
It's a good question, John. Let's look at it and find out.
If you see that a chick has yellow feathers like this and isn't a human woman, but if you see one of us and we don't have feathers and we're not a baby chicken, shouldn't call us a chick. Does that make sense?
Does it?
Sounds like being an adult is really complicated.
Actually, it really isn't.
What else do I need to know?
Lesson just went really well.
I lied earlier when I said that I had friends and they just couldn't make it. I actually just don't have a lot of friends at all. Like, zero friends. I just moved here from Milwaukee.
Are we sure you're in the right room?
Are we in the right room? Shouldn't there be more kids here?
It seems like less of a friendship issue and more of a logistical situation.
What was the first lesson we learned? Never turn down a lesson, even if it's not the one you were supposed to be teaching. So,
Michael.
Light bulb. That was the last word of the quote. I always forget it. So, let's talk about friends. Pretend this chicken is someone who you want to be friends with. What would you do to it? Well, picking it up is already bad. You can't do that.
If it's a chicken.
I'm not allowed to just go out and pick up chicks.
Okay, Martin, when we open these doors, the time machine may have taken us back to the year 3000 BC, so there's no telling what's out there.
May have.
What's up?
What are you?
We are human beings from 1899.
We don't have nothing.
Yes. But they have language.
Do we ever come on out?
Come on out, man. If we're about to have supper, please join us.
I have a gas mask. You don't know if they're tricking us.
I will also bring my gun.
We're friendly dinosaurs.
How did you just come into our...
She's
like a great chicken, though. It's on the barbie now.
She's got onions. Leave her alone.
Thanks, guys.
I also made veggie burgers if you don't eat meat, just like me. No judgment here.
Matthew, I don't even know so much. Whoa, what am I trying to say?
Are you okay?
Yeah. No, what I'm saying is that I don't know if we should be asking ourselves when this is, but rather where.
Oh, this is Pangaea!
Yes.
There's only one big land. There's no, you just kind of wander around it and eat whatever you
want. There are seven very distinct continental divides on it, though, that might one day be landmass.
Is this sculpture? This sculpture your leader?
No, that is something I made of coral.
You can't lead a damn thing.
In the history books.
Hey, if you guys...
Creative God!
You're right.
If you guys are from the future, can you tell us what happens to us? Are we friends for, like, forever?
Forever! I'm gonna get in the machine. You do what you have to do.
Please consider coming back.
Your shoes are stupider, you know. At least with the nurse, they had a uniform. When you leave it up to yourself, you look like an idiot.
That really hurts. Okay. Do you know the kind of effect bullying has on people? you know how much it hurts to go to work day after day and be told that your hair looks like a fishnet tossed into the sea? And be told that your eyes look like glass? How my body looks like, okay?
Look, I'm sorry. I don't know how to express myself, but we came for a reason. We need you back. The new girl's a nightmare.
It's a nightmare.
She gave me a cocktail of pills that didn't make me hard and didn't make me high.
Prayed for you to come back, but it's taking me too long to stand back up.
Listen, do you think if I could come back, I would? Because I would. I would come back, but I can't.
Push me over to
come
him.
Back. I don't know.
Thanks for coming to Subway. We're super happy to have you on board here. Basically, to be a sandwich artist, and you just have to just work your way down. First, you ask them what kind of bread they want, and then you get the meat, and you put the meat on, or whatever else they want on their sandwiches, and then you just work your way down the line and ask them for a lot of toppings. It's just like a super easy job, but it's like a real important job, because when people need a sandwich at lunch, then you can't fuck it up, all right?
Well, if I... Hopefully I don't get bullied here.
Dude,
white or wheat?
I didn't even say what sandwich I wanted. If I want a salad. Sorry, you have some glass-eyed
What is it gonna be next? The type of belts I wear? Hey, listen, it's called fashion. Alright? I just like a big buckle. There's no reason to make fun of me for it, okay?
Hey, so welcome to Hot Topic. Glad you're here. Like, you know, and like, just treat, like, the people,
right.
You know,
to
their questions.
Yeah,
you got this, yeah.
You want this
Is
bright
that a
eye
Saves
shirt?
The Day shirt?
Where'd you get that here? Sarah, what? Listen, remember that time sophomore year when Ryan and I kind of smooched after a
few
years?
Oh my god, so smooch? Yeah, I remember.
Well, it turns out he's some super secret spy, but I think he's just trying to break up with me in like a friend way, like a friend breakup. I don't know.
Okay, which one of those things you'd want me to deal with first? Spy or breakup as a friend?
Just friend breakup.
Friend breakup? Maybe just see what he says.
He says a lot of confusing things. I got very confused. It felt accusatory because of my heritage from Lithuania.
That's not your fault.
Don, I think you've done a good job of confusing her, and, you know, she thinks that you love her, or maybe, I don't know, that smooch was behind the curtains, I didn't approve of that. So what I'm going to need you to do is apologize and get close to her, and I'll be here the whole time, looking through her stuff.
Alright. Over
Wait, did you send you this text that said, I'm sorry and I want to get close to you?
Yeah, and then it had the emoji with the smiley with his hands like this.
Okay, look, he will be here imminently. Judging by the emoji, I don't know. I'm going to be in the closet. Okay.
Oh, Sarah. Coming.
HVAC system. It's been all wonky ever since Mr. McCaffrey frogs got loose. Why don't you see?
You frogs, sir! They're in the air ducts!
What?
Yes, you frogs!
No!
I can't get them out!
Oh, no,
the whole acoustics in this space is off now!
Oh, damn it! By the way, good diversion with the frogs. Ribbit?
We've had a frog problem.
Text for Allie.
Hold on, I got a text from Sarah.
He's whispering to someone. Monkey emoji?
I think we might smooch. Look away.
Honey, I am so proud of you for going to that test kindergarten.
I invited both of your teachers to babysit for you while I'm running for office across the country.
We're here at the same time from different doors.
Women are surprising. That's another lesson.
And for the first round of the political debate between the upcoming senator, I have a question. I've heard that you are pushing for kind of a goofy kindergarten for your own children. Would you like to respond to that?
Yep.
I think that was directed at me.
Okay.
Was that directed at me?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I don't like the word goofy. When we think goofy, I think we think of that big dog at Disney. And I think
is there a rebuttal?
Oh, you betcha. You betcha there's a rebuttal because it
listen, Mr. Cytophin. I don't think that you haven't been to Disney before. I've seen photos of you.
Okay, this is not about whether or not I have been to Disney.
But isn't it?
This is not. People giving a little side of fin.
Wait, but have you been to Disney?
We have questions from the audience.
This is a town hall.
We love the dog.
Okay. Well, this,
and if so, could you specify whether it was Disneyland or Disney World or both at separate times?
I'd like to say I've been to all three parks and visited the upcoming one in Beijing.
Seems fake.
And it does seem fake.
Man, you did really well in that debate. Anyway, here are your talking points for the missile crisis going on in Cuba. We've got a French Ebola outbreak, a Russian thing going on in Lithuania. On top of that, I got a little word from your son's teachers.
No.
He's turning into quite the little anti-feminist.
No! No! Bring him to me!
Mom, or dick.
Guys, it looks like the feds are coming here.
What?
I think that we can still remain a cult even if they break us apart. We just can't lose sight of our ideals and what we believe in.
That might be it for us.
No!
Y'all, you know I got the rocket launchers in back.
Don't worry, I didn't make this closet for nothing.
Why don't the feds understand us?
Wait, Pastor Jared, is everything you ever told us true? That the world wasn't invented by...
Yes, the world was invented by tadpoles. And everything that they put together was...
Your fans are coming! Be fast about it!
Would you all give me some
investigation
space?
Coming to identify another cult.
Honey, when I have a day in his life, like this giant dog who couldn't fit through doors.
That would be so coincidental. No.
Wouldn't it? I hope the best for him.
I do too.
Let's write him a letter for him to read in 20 years.
Open it. Open it. Just see what it says. Your parents aren't here anymore, but we need to know. I love you, husband.
Let's see. Dear Clifford.
That's you.
And don't think just because we got married I'm going to forgive you for stealing my job and giving out shitty pills.
I'm a scientist, and you were just making them hard and high the whole time.
Hey, what's up? It's me again. This is Steve. You guys met Steve the earlier in the show. I always thought that, like, people would like that I have an iguana, but they don't think he's as cute, I'm sorry, she is as cute and cuddly as a dog, but, ma'am, is it okay? I'm just gonna rest him around your shoulder.
You can't just say he or she like that. It doesn't matter. You need to respect no matter what, and it could be any name that you want.
Ma'am,
leave a little bit in there if you feel so generous this holiday season. Thank you guys so much for coming.